Welcome back to our continuing coverage of Pope Francis's historic visit to America. I'm Poppy Harlow.
And I'm Dick Tapper. We're just minutes away from the Pope's arrival at Independence Hall in downtown Philadelphia, where he will deliver a speech to a crowd of tens of thousands. An even bigger crowd is expected behind me here up near the Philadelphia Art Museum for the Pope's address at the Festival of Families tonight. Christian music star Matt Maher is one of the opening acts. This isn't the first time Maher has performed at a major event with the Pope. Let's take a little listen here to him at the 2013 World Youth Day in Rio, Brazil.
Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart.
All right. Nice. And Matt Maher, five-time Grammy nominee, joining us now here in Philadelphia. His latest album is entitled Saints and Sinners. He's just wrapped up sound check behind us. He joins us in the booth. You got to be pretty excited. I guess this isn't the first time you've performed with the Pope, though.
No, but it is a bit surreal every couple of years to play for more people than you, too. You know, it's a bit bizarre. So you kind of have to adjust things.
This is the second time that you've done it with the Pope, or?
Yeah, I've been to about, I've actually played it. World Youth Day is an event that happens every 3 years. I've been playing at them since 2000. So I was at 2002 with Pope John Paul II.
Oh, wow.
2007 with Pope Benedict. And then Rio two years ago. Yeah, with Pope Francis.
So you've had the opportunity to perform and spend time with all three of them.
Yeah, well, I'm usually playing around them. I'm not really performing.
Be in their presence.
Yeah.
And frankly, see the reaction of the people responding to them.
Yeah.
What is different now?
Well, I think this whole meeting, World Meeting of Families, is really the culmination of this whole visit. And I think this whole visit, you know, the thing about families, you don't get to choose your family. Whoever you're with, you're stuck together. And along the way, you got to work things out because you're with each other. And I think this Pope, what's different about it is I think he's trying to call everybody together and say, look, we're here, we're on this planet, we're with each other. We got to learn to live together. We got to learn to love each other, you know. Be about reconciliation, be about forgiveness. And I think, you know, other popes said the same thing, but I think this pope has changed the tone so much. He's an expert communicator. I don't know if it's his Jesuit background or his intellect, but it's just a gift that God's given him, this ability, I think, to communicate things simply, succinctly, and with great passion, and everybody kind of resonates with it.
And this pope, obviously, as you know, some conservatives preferred Benedict,
right.
Frankly. They don't like the emphasis that this pope gives things.
Yes.
How do you feel, and how does the Christian music community feel, if I may designate you to speak on behalf of them?
Yeah. Usually, I'm the token Catholic in the Christian music industry. So, you know, all my friends, they all love him who aren't Catholic. And I think, once again, you know, John Paul is the mystic. Benedict's the teacher. You know, Francis is the heart. He speaks with the language of the heart. I think a language that people can understand. I think it does. For some conservatives, they're like, well, wait, you weren't specific enough. And there's people like that in the church. But I think the bigger thing is about, once again, I think the age and the time in which we're living, I think the leadership that he's exemplifying for the whole church is we got to create space for everyone. We got to create a sense of dialogue where people, you know, Christianity is about a pilgrimage. It's about a journey from earth to heaven. It's not about just a singular moment. It's not about doing right things to be a good person. It's about knowing that God loves you and that he's chasing after your whole life, you know? And I think American Catholicism, the legacy, not just of the people that the Holy Fathers mentioned, like Dorothy Day and St. Catherine Drexel,
right.
But also great literary giants, you know, Tolkien, name's blanking on me, but Southern Gothic writer, Flannery O'Connor. These people, powerful Catholics, but they weren't perfect.
Yeah.
And I think he's trying to create a church that's not about perfection, but it's about the journeying to saint from sinner.
So how has he and how has his papacy so far affected your music? Has it what you've chosen write about?
Huge. The moment he was elected, the things he started saying resonated with me for a long time. I think just the message of grace and forgiveness, the whole idea of that we need to not be a church that's inclusive, or exclusive, sorry, but we need to be a church that pushes out to the peripheries. You know, I'm a musician. Musician and artist types, we're messy people. We're not perfect. Mm-hmm. And I think this whole notion of inviting people on a journey of faith that that is just as much about the journey itself and not just the destination, I think that's authentic Christianity.
What are you going to perform?
I'm going to be singing three songs tonight, one of which is the one I performed in Rio, Lord, I Need You, and then a song called Because He Lives, sort of a modern adaptation out of Bill Gaither's song. Mm-hmm. And then probably my favorite is a song called Hold Us Together. And it really is this notion of that love is something that transcends politics. It transcends, ideology and the things that, you know, we tend to stay tribalistic or encamped in. And I think the love of Jesus, it spreads out into all areas, and it invites everybody to be reminded that we're part of a human family.
Well, we're really looking forward to it. Best of luck out there.
Thank you so much.
What a night it's going to be. Yeah. Thank you. Nice to meet
you. Welcome.
We appreciate it. Thank you. Good to have you on. The Pope expected to depart the seminary any minute. He is heading right there to Independence Hall. You're looking at live pictures.